everybody. My name's Wes. It's been a while. I haven't taken a shower yet today, so I'm sorry about that. If you're like me, you've fallen for the trap about having succulents and cool things like that in your house or apartment or bedroom. And if you're like me, they just die. And if they don't die, they look really ugly, like this. I don't know what's happening. There's dead leaves. It grew out over here. And I'm actually super horrible to this thing. I think I watered it like a month ago. But I did give it a happy, cool little home that I got from the thrift store. So I've been looking around online, and today I'm going to attempt to repot this and trim it down. And so hopefully that goes well, and we can all learn a new trick about having cool succulents when you live in a city and you're trying to be cool. All right, I have no idea what I'm doing, so let's just go for it. All right, that was pretty easy. See if I can't save some of the dirt here. And let's get rid of these guys. Yeah, let's just go for it. I think to be safe, we'll just take it up here. I'm gonna call that good to go. Huh? Pretty good. Aloe plants are supposed to be good for having in your bedroom. So I just bought that. I don't have a pot for it, and I couldn't find a cool one in IKEA like I was hoping for. So I got a glass. I think it's technically pink, but it doesn't look like that. So we're gonna use that instead. At the bottom of my first succulent, there are rocks in there, and that's to keep the roots from rotting. So about this much of it is rocks, and then there's the dirt on top of it. So that way, if I pour too much water, it goes down and it doesn't actually affect the roots. So we're gonna do that here. I did find all these little rocks from outside my apartment. So I think someone's goldfish died and then they emptied the aquarium. All right, let's just go for it.